Good evening, sir.
Can you remind me where we ended up last time? Stability of resonating structures, I guess, right?
Yes, sir.
Stability of resonating structures. Okay, fine, great.
And then, now, completed like rules for stability and all.
Rules for stability, and we did some questions also?
Yeah.
Okay, fine. So let me move forward. Okay, I'm just giving you 4-5 minutes. I'm giving you 1 minute. Just go over the pages of the last class. And okay. I'm writing some more questions.
Okay, sir.
Done, Jumaina?
1 minute.
Okay, fine.
So only one question?
No. I am not asking. I am asking you to go over the pages.
Okay.
I have not given the question till now.
Okay, sir.
This is structure A. B will be. These few bonds, I guess. And this one will be negative. Wait a second, let me make this. A negative, that means this minus NO2, O negative. Plus and minus coordinate bond is there. Okay, fine, great. But this will happen, this will go this side, and this will go this side, so this will be double bonded like this. Negative, positive, negative, and I will get a, this bond has moved here, get a positive here, and like this. See, I can make it like this. Positive, this is negative. Look on here. Tell me about these and another question is which is most stable? A. B would be this one. Between these two, these are resonating structures. No? Between these two, which is more stable? And write one more if I can see it. A, B, C, D, and this is A and B. Which of the following is least stable, the following, and which is most stable between these two.
Sir, in question number one, do we have to just mention that one element which is least stable, or like do we have to write them
you just have to pick one of them, A, B, C, D. Which of the following is least stable? Don't compare. You don't have to compare which one. I mean, you don't have to give the A, yes, B, then C. You don't have to compare. You just have to tell me which of them is least stable, because it has a very obvious answer.
Okay, sir.
Okay. And then next. Done.
Completing the question.
My question is complete. Are you done? Actually, you are just right. Okay, you are done completing the questions. Tell me when you have solved the question.
Sir, how to prepare for a chemistry practical viva?
Chemistry practical viva?
Yes, sir.
Have you done the practicals?
Like in school? Last year we did. This year we didn't win, but then they asked to complete our records and all.
So they asked you to complete the records and all. Most probably they will be lenient, okay, but you have no idea about practical chemistry?
No, we know. I know, because we had done in 11th standard, 10th and all.
But in 12th standard, what are the things that you have? You must be having some titrations and
is there analysis of simple salts is there, then organic group.
functional groups would be there.
That's it.
So you know them, na? Or no idea?
Yeah, I know how to do.
You know how to do them, you will be fine. Just revise the things, and most importantly, be a bit confident. And if you know how to, just keep up them in. I mean, I will misdirect in some things. Tell them anything that you know. If the question that has been posed to you, you don't know that question, then turn it in some way to the answer that you know.
Okay, sir.
Okay, for example, if they ask about alcoholic group, you just convert the answer to an aldehyde group if you know the aldehyde group. Okay. I mean, okay. Emphasize. First, alcohol, sir, I think this is there. And for alcohol, if we oxidize alcohol, then it will get aldehyde. And for aldehyde, this is the test, sir. So, at least convey if you know some things. Is there noise from my side?
No, sir.
No? Okay, fine. I mean, there is some constant beating, hammering going on somewhere.
But it's done.
Yes, tell me.
It's there, but then it's not that clear.
There is something tap, no?
Yes, sir. But not that clear.
Okay, fine. Are you done with the question?
One minute, sir. Now I'll do it.
Acha. Done. You are taking too much time now.
Yes, for first question, A is my answer.
A is your answer for the first question. Okay, fine. And what about question two?
Question two, I'm confused, sir.
You are confused in question two? Okay, fine. Let us deal with the question one. Question one, A is not the correct answer. D is the correct answer. D is the least stable because, see, nitrogen here is pentavalent. Correct? 5 bonds. And this can never happen. Can never happen. Why? Why? Because nitrogen is second period element, and second period elements, they follow octet rule. Correct?
Yes, sir.
This was a bit. Tell me.
But then, sir, we even look for the number of covalent bonds, right? So the more covalent bond is there, it's like it's stable, na?
So carbon has 6 bonds and one carbon has 4 bonds. Which one is more stable?
One bond.
One carbon has 6 bonds. Okay. And just imagine that. It can never happen, na? Exactly, it can never happen. So if something can never happen, then that is most unstable, na? Most unstable. If we do anything and just get a CH6, then this will be not stable. CH4 is rather more stable. So you have to also consider the number of electrons that a shell can have. So nitrogen can never have pentavalent, na? Nitrogen or any second period element can never have pentavalent, because as soon as we say pentavalent, it means how many electrons? 5 bonds. And in 5 bonds, in each bond, we have 2 electrons. So 5 and 2 into 5 is equal to 10 electrons. And 10 electrons, it violates the octet rule. Okay, coming to second question, we have 2 structures. In this structure, what is happening? In this structure, there is resonance. Okay, this is resonance. We have to minimize this, correct? Minimize this positive charge. So for minimizing the positive charge, we have resonance that will give us some minimization. Okay, fine. But it also has inductive effect, plus I effect in A structure. What about B? In B, what happens is, and also this, let me make this here. This is positive. Now this carbon is sp3, and that is why this is plus I effect, and this carbon is sp2, and hence it is minus I effect showing. Okay, now what about second structure? In that second structure, we have only one sp2, which is minus I will withdraw the electrons and make it more positive. And what will happen here? Minus I will try to pull the electrons, but this sp3 carbon, it will also give electrons, and if it gives electron, the charge will be lowered. So here the charge is minimized more, and hence A is more stable than B. Did you get it? No. Yes. Yes, anything?
Yes, sir.
Got it, no? Okay. Now let us move on to mesomeric effect. Mm-hmm. mesomeric effect. What is mesomeric effect? Is it loud now?
No, sir.
That thak thak thak.
No, it's not disturbing.
Yes, it's not disturbing. Okay, fine then. What is mesomeric effect? It is defined as the movement of pi electron towards or away. Movement of which electrons? Pi electrons towards or away from a substituent group. What does this mean? Means that if we have something like this, H2 carbon double bond CH, let us take this CH, then we have again CH double bond CH double bond, then we will have a CH2, or we will have a CH here. CH2. Wait a second. If I make it OH like this directly, then this will be fine. Now, wait a second. I will make this OH. Now we have lone pair here. One electron here. Then the another electron will be there. So what is happening here? Electron away from substituent group, and hence this will be positive M. This will be positive M. Similarly, if we have something like this, H2C double bond CH, and then we have, let us say, nitrogen double bond single bond O, double bond then single bond O. Now what will happen here? This pi electron will move towards oxygen, and this will move here. Electron towards substituent group. Now this will be called as minus M effect. This plus M effect. In plus M effect, what is happening? The electrons are moving away from the functional group, and in plus M effect, the electrons are moving towards the substituent group of the functional group. Now, one thing we have to remember is that it may look like resonating structure. It may look like resonating structures or resonance, but it is not resonance. It is not resonance. In fact, we can say that all resonance are not mesomeric. All resonance are not mesomeric effect. For example, if we have something like this, CH3, then C double bond O, and then H. So we write one resonating structure like this now, CH3, then C, this will go to here, and H, and this is single bond O negative, and this is positive. Okay. Now this particular ketonic aldehydic group, electron is not moving anywhere from aldehydic group. Okay, so resonance is everywhere. I mean, in all the mesomeric structure, all the mesomeric effect, the resonance will be there, but all resonance are not mesomeric, but all mesomeric effect are resonance. So the idea about mesomeric effect is towards or away from the substituent group. This substituent group is the key word here in the mesomeric effect. Otherwise, resonance, it is a phenomena. Resonance is a phenomena. It does not have to do anything with the substituent group. Okay, mesomeric effect. Now, as soon as I say substituent group, now this has become very tunnel and channel viewed towards the organic chemistry only. Correct. But resonance can be anywhere. A mesomeric effect, it is the movement of pi electron towards or away from the substituent group. Okay. So, are you with me till here?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, you understand this point, na? All resonance are not mesomeric. For example, this one. This is not mesomeric effect. This is just resonance, just pure simple resonance. But all the mesomeric effect are resonance. Okay, this is not mesomeric effect. This is not plus or minus F. Okay, the particular this resonating structure that we have shown here. Okay, just note this down.
Done, sir.
Okay, great. Now, as I said, plus M and minus M. So we'll look at first of all. Keep red pen. Positive M effect, or we call it as plus M. We call it plus M effect. Positive or plus M. Now, example that we can see here is. And in positive and plus M effect, you will always see one thing, that is lone pair electron on the substituent. Wait a second, not substituent, let me say key atom. I will define the key atom here, lone pair on the key atom, or you will find a negative charge on the key atom. What is key atom? Definition for key atom will be, this is not a chemical definition. We are just using this word key atom for our ease only, just for the sake of our ease. Key atom is the atom that is directly connected to the carbon skeleton. Okay. So as soon as you see something which has either a lone pair or negative charge on the key atom, a functional group which has a key atom and in which you see lone pair or negative charge, that means you will understand that this will show a positive M effect. That means the electron flow will be away from the, let me write that also. Electron flow away from group. I think you know this. How to draw the various resonating structures for this one? Let's say NH2. You can do this, right? And this will move here, then what will happen? This will move here, then this will move here. So we will get a new resonating structure. Now the benzenes are difficult to draw with a stylus, but in the meantime, I will get used to it. NH2, and here we will have a negative charge, then here we will have these two. Then this is plain simple like this, and this will become here, and we will get. Now this will be positive charge. Now it has four bonds. Double bond, nitrogen H2 positive. And then here we will have this type of structure and a negative charge. Now this will move here and this will move here. Again, we will get a new structure. Double bond NH2 will remain as such, and a negative charge here and a bond here and a bond here. Now the last thing will be happening like this. Now this is NH2 with a lone pair, and we have alternating double and single bonds that have changed the double and single bond position if we drew the resonating structure, that if we completed all the resonating structures. Okay. Now what we see here is, the important point to see here is, in this, due to this effect, due to plus M effect, the certain groups, I mean certain positions in the ring, correct? Are you there?
Yes, sir.
Due to plus M effect, certain positions in the molecule, or here it is ring, or generally in the molecule, certain position in the molecule becomes electron rich. Okay, now just imagine how the people would be. They reacted these species. For example, let us take plus, let me take for example CH3 Cl. The CH3 Cl can be broken into two parts, CH3 plus and then Cl negative. Now they imagine, where will the CH3 positive go? Where will the CH3 positive go? This is super old alkylation, Friedel-Crafts alkylation, and we use AlCl3 here. What do you think? What would the first initial guess would be? It will be like, maybe it can replace hydrogen because it has this particular nitrogen with a lone pair. Some would have said, okay, fine, maybe it can attack the benzene ring and it can form anywhere like this, either here or here or here. I mean, they would have assumed that I will get at least three structures, correct?
Yes, sir.
Anna, but what happened? We didn't get this structure. We only got this structure and this structure. Now, then the reason would have, what would be the reason? That would be resonance, because when we see the real structure of NH2, if we see the real structure, then if we want to put the resonance hybrid structure, it would be like this. Now, all these are double bonds. So hence I can write as a ring type of thing. And this is also partial double bond. And this is NH2. And this is delta positive, if I am right. See, it has positive charge in so many resonating structures, correct? Now, where are the delta negative parts? Here is delta negative, and here is delta negative, and here is delta negative. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Right, na? That is why by resonance, we can predict the reaction. By resonance, we can predict the reaction. Okay. Now, I can write one more point. Ortho and para position. You know about ortho and para?
Yeah, it's a different positions in benzene ring.
Okay, fine. But do you know which is ortho, which is ortho, which is para?
Should I say in this one?
Yes, you can say. You can tell you 1, 2, 3. Out of 1, 2, 3, which is 4 and 5. Which of them are ortho and which is para?
One is para.
One is para. Nope. Okay, fine. I will let you know. Don't worry. I will let you know. Ortho and para position get.
Okay, 1 and 4 is ortho and 5, 2 is para.
No, don't guess. Don't repeat wrong things. Okay, don't say. Electron rich. Okay, now to ortho parameter. Here is the group. This is the benzene ring. I mean, these are all bonds like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay, first of all, tell me, can I say 1 and 5 are same?
Yes, sir.
Okay, and what else is same? 2 and 4?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And 3. We have 3 positions. Exactly, if we say we have 3 positions. 1 and 5 are same, 2 or 4 and 3. So 1 and 5 are called ortho. Okay. What is 1 and 5? Not like this. I will let you know. 2 and 4 is called meta. And the 3 is called para. 3 is called para. Ortho, meta, and para. Okay, ortho, meta, and para. Correct? Ortho, meta, para. You will remember it's like this. Ortho, meta, para. Okay, now you tell me. Tell me, which are ortho? which is ortho?
3 and 4 is ortho.
Yeah, and meta?
5, 2 is meta and 1 is para.
Okay, fine. That means you can now recognize it. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So this was all about plus MFF. But one thing that you should notice, one thing that should be noted is in halogens, all show plus M effect. Okay, they also plus M effect. That means via pi electrons, what they are doing? They are donating the electrons. Via, that means that is electron donation via pi electrons. But halogens are highly minus I. What does that mean? That is electron withdrawal. Electron withdrawal via sigma electrons. If you remember inductive effect, it is pulling or pushing of electrons via sigma bonds. But so what is dominant here? In halogens, minus I is dominant. What does that mean? It means that even though products of the haloalkenes, the products of anything which is like this. Now X here, it represent halogen. What it is doing? It is deactivating. What does that mean? It is pulling electrons, but in the same order, in the same way as all plus M effect, it is ortho para directing. Okay, it is also ortho para directing, but it is deactivating. Now deactivation, it is because the net effect is of pulling electron. But even though if you pull electron, the resonating structures would always be there. Resonating structure will always be there. And this will be delta negative always. This will be delta negative. In comparison to other plus M effects, other plus M groups, halogens show a deactivating nature. Okay. Just note this down. Did you note this one? Yes, you have noted this one. Note this down also.
Sir, can you take last slide? Okay, sir.
Done. Sorry. Too soon. All right.
Done, sir.
Okay, great. Now we will next move to the minus M effect, the negative mesomeric effect. Wait a second. I'm sorry for that. What is negative mesomeric effect? Now you have to understand this is also known as minus M. So first thing, what it will say is that all the minus M group, it moves the electron, moves electron towards the group. In minus M, what will happen? The flow of electrons will be towards the group. Flow of electron will be towards the group. What is it? Okay, now how to recognize minus M? How to recognize minus M? It is very easy. The key atom is attached to electronegative atom. What is electronegative atom? For example, it will be either fluorine, oxygen, nitrogen, etc. Now key atom is attached to electronegative atom via double bond. All of them will show minus M effect. That means it will pull the electron. For example, the most common example is NO2, nitrogen, which has a double bond here and a coordinate bond with this oxygen. Now, how does the effect goes on? This electron will move towards oxygen, and this will move here. Now we have to move those two electrons because we know keep nitrogen for that. Oh, negative. Now this will be negative. This will be also negative. And here we'll be having like this. Here we'll be having like this. Now, as soon as this has got 1, 2, 3 bonds, this will be positive. Right? Now, this will not be positive. This is one is coordinate bond, or one is coordinate bond, then this will not be positive. Sorry. This has a coordinate bond, and hence this will be not positive. What will be positive is this one. Correct? Because we have moved electrons from there. Now it becomes simple. We'll be having double bond NO negative. Here also O negatives, and a plus charge will be gaining here. Will be a plus charge there again. Simple. Double bond N, single bond O negative, single bond O negative, and pi bond here, and the positive charge here. Next would be like this. Now single bond nitrogen. As soon as this goes here, this will go here. Double bond O, single bond O. Okay, sorry, I have given some more negatives here. I don't know why. And then this is here, this is here, this is here. If I have not given negative, I have to make this coordinate bond. This is also coordinate bond. This is also coordinate bond. This is also coordinate bond. Okay. Now what we can see here is we are getting minus M effect decreases the electron density at ortho and para position. Correct? At ortho and para position. What are the other examples would be? Other examples you can see. For example, if I have carbon double bond O, and if I have H here, again, what is the key atom? This is the key atom, right? This is a functional group. Now, this whole is a functional group, which is called aldehyde. Now, in aldehyde group, which is the key atom? The carbon is the key atom because it is directly attached to the benzene ring. And this carbon is also attached to electronegative atom via double bond. Now, other example can be double bond O, and if I get a CH3. Okay, again, this is what ketonic group. This is ketone. And another example can be of carboxylic acid if you want. C double bond O, and if I have OH here. And this carbon here, it is also attached to an electronegative atom, and this carbon is the key atom, and this is acid group. Carboxylic acid, I'm just writing in short, carboxylic acid group. What else? Now, write this much, then you will do some questions, okay? I will not tell each and everything now. just remember how to recognize plus m and minus m. Plus m, the key atom has lone pair or negative charge. Minus m, the key atom is attached to electronegative atom via double bond. Key atom attached to electronegative element via double bond.
Done, sir.
Done? Okay, fine. Now I'll take a question. Arrange the following in increasing order of electron density. Electron density in the ring. Now, why ring? Why ring is the skeleton? Ring is the skeleton. For example, A, I have a phenolic group like this. By the way, Jubaina, where are others? I don't see anyone else.
I don't know, sir.
You don't know?
No, sir.
B is cyanide group, C triple bond N. C is good old vanilla benzene. Now you have to arrange the following. You have to arrange it. Okay. You don't have to take the highest electron density. Arrange the following. First of all, if you have A, then just write what is happening there, plus M or minus M. In B, write what is happening, plus M, minus M, plus I, minus M, whatever is happening. And in C, what is happening.
Try this, and if you are stuck, let me know.
Done, Jumaina?
The first one is done.
First one is done?
Yes, sir.
Okay, great. Try the second one. Now you have to arrange this in increasing order of acidic strength. Increasing order of acidic strength. I have taken phenol with some substituent groups. A, B, we have same OH, but here we have a substituent group, which is, let us take CH3, C, same OH, and let us take, what should I take? C triple bond N and D take OH and let me take an O2. Don't do the third one, this acidic order. First do for these two and let me know. Don't even write this question right now. Done with the second one, Jubaina?
No, sir.
Stuck somewhere?
Yes, sir, somewhat.
Okay, tell me about the first one. What is the order?
For first one, B, A, C.
Increasing order of electron density, na?
Yes, sir.
So B has lowest.
Yes, sir.
Then?
A, then C.
You can see, okay, fine. But first of all, tell me, what is the effect going on in phenol in this group in A? What is the effect? Plus M or minus M?
It's plus M.
Plus M. That means electron density increases, yes, in the ring. Away, this side, the electron density will increase. Okay, what about this CN? Plus M or minus M?
Minus M.
Minus M. That means electron density will decrease. Electron density decrease. What about benzene?
Benzene, it's plus M.
Are no effect, na? It is no effect. See, you have to take this much. What is here? Here it is H, na?
Yes, sir.
So no effect here. No group, so no effect.
Okay.
Okay. So what will be the answer? The answer will be?
CBA.
BCA. B is the lowest, then C, then A. B, why? Because the electron density is the least here. And why C? Because it has no effect and electron density is highest at A. Correct? B, C, then A. Right or wrong? Right now?
It should be C, B, because C doesn't have any effect, right? At least B has
no
effect
over there. No, but it is what effect it is having? Electron donation or electron pulling?
Pulling.
So first of all, it would be benzene. If you remove the CN, then it was benzene. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Here, there will be some electron density. Let us take, for example, just an example, 5 unit. Okay. Now what I did, I added CN here. Now what will be the what will be the electron density? It will be less than 5, no? It will be less than 5, no?
Yes, sir.
Correct? Less than 5 unit. Okay, fine. You understood why C is?
Yes, I got it, sir. Okay.
Now, also, even though we have here minus M, minus I, here also we have carbon and nitrogen after that minus I, but when plus M is there, we don't consider minus I except for halogens. I have told you in the note, na? Halogens have deactivating. That means it in net, what they do? They pull the electron. What is dominant? Minus I is dominant. Hence, when we have halogens, we see the inductive effect also. For example, let us see here. What is happening here? Plus M and minus I. Minus I because oxygen is electronegative atom. Okay, minus I, but it will be very little and plus M will dominate. Plus M will dominate. What about chlorine? It has plus M and minus I. Now, what is dominant here? Minus I is dominant, correct? Here, what is dominant? Plus M, so I'm erasing minus I. What is dominant here? Cl is, so minus I. Got it or no?
Got it.
Got it. What about CH3? It has plus I, correct? No? Yes?
Yes, sir.
NO2 has?
Minus M.
NO2 has? Minus M. Okay. So when we compare minus M, so this particular minus M will be the least electron density. It will be having least electron density. Hence, we will write D. Then we will look at another minus. What is else minus? Inductive effect. Inductive effect. Then we will write inductive effect has some more. That is B. Then we will write what has next plus. I will write plus I because if we compare plus M and plus I will be greater, hence plus I will be in the increasing order. Then we will get plus M. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Now, here what I need is for this question to attempt, you have to know the order of plus M group and minus M group. Between the plus M's, if we have, for example, OH group and NH2 group, both are plus M. But who is more plus M? Which is more electron donating? That you have to know. So order. Order of, first we will see the minus M groups. Order of minus M. Minus M, you will have the most minus M by a CH2 positive. Okay. Because it is positively charged. Then you will have the most of NO2. Then you will have C triple bond N. Then you will have C OOH, that is acidic carboxylic acid group. Then you will have ketonic group C R double bond O, like this. This is ketonic group. And then you will have aldehydic group, that is CHO. Got it?
Sir, it's like increasing order of acidic group, right?
Not acidic. This question has to be attempted after we have learned this concept.
Okay.
Order of minus M.
Okay.
Okay. Now order of plus M will be order of plus M. Anything that is CH2 negative. Negative charge in the key atom will have the most plus M effect. Then you will have NH negative. Again, negative charge on the key atom. Then you will have O negative. O negative. Then you will have NH2. Then you will have OH. Then you will have OR. That is ether. Then you will have NH. I'm writing H here and C double bond O, ME. Then at last you will be having OCOR, ester group. OCOR, ester group. Okay. So initially both in minus M, what is coming? The positively charged CH2 plus NO2, then C triple bond N, COOH, RCO, that is ketonic group, then the aldehydic group. Then CH2, NH negative, O negative, NH2, then OH, then ether, then NHC double bond OME, then ester group. Note this down. note this down, then we will attempt this question of acidic character. Done.
1 minute, sir.
Okay.
Done, sir.
Great. Now let us look at this question. We have CH3, CN, and NO2. Wait a second. Let me make those compounds again. I have nothing here. We have CH3. We have C triple bond N. And then we have NO2. Okay. All of them have OH. This also OH. This also has OH. This also has OH. Now, what they are asking is the acidic strength. They are asking the acidic strength. So I have told you what you have to do. You have to make the conjugate base of the acid. Correct, Jubana?
Yes, sir.
Hana, and then if I make the conjugate base of this one, what will, which is the acidic hydrogen, which will be removed from here, this H, correct?
Yes, sir.
Right or wrong? This will be removed. So what we will be getting? O negative. Correct or not?
Yes, sir.
And here what we'll be getting? O negative and CH3. So what do you want? If you want to minimize this O negative group, then you must have something which is O negative. Then you must have something which is electron withdrawing. Right or wrong?
Yes, sir.
We can say that it's electron withdrawing groups will stabilize the conjugate base and make the acid more acidic. Correct? More acidic. Right, Jubana. Now you will tell me, Jubana. Yeah. I mean, focus okay. Here. And tell me, think and tell me, what effect is in A? What effect is in A?
Negative. I mean, minus M.
How minus M? How minus M? Tell me fast.
Say 1 minute. Because the key atom is attached to electron,
which is the key atom
C. I mean, No. O is a key atom, right? Here.
So, and O will be, first of all, leave that. Leave that. Tell me, this has OH, A has OH, B has OH, C also has OH, D also has OH, correct?
Yes, sir.
So, will the OH make any difference if you are comparing?
No.
No, no. You don't have to. Achha. Benzene ring. All of them have benzene ring?
Yes, sir.
Now, next is the substituent group. What is here? Here, we have H. And here, we have CH3, here CN, and here NO2. So, what matters is what is in this position. What is in the... What is the substituent group? Correct? Now you tell me which effect is here. No effect, na?
Yes, sir.
This brings you the benzene. So no effect. First here is no effect. Okay. That means it is not stabilizing. It is not also destabilizing. It is just nothing. No effect. What about B? What effect is here?
Plus M.
Plus M or plus I?
Plus
CS3, I. Na? Plus I. CS3 is not showing plus M. It is showing plus I. Okay. That means... Plus I, that means electron donating. Okay, right or not, Jubana? Electron donating, na?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now electron donating with stabilize or it will destabilize the conjugate base. We have this structure, na? We have this structure, O negative, the conjugate base, and we have what? CH3. So what do we want? We want to minimize this or maximize this? We have to minimize this. Correct?
Yes,
now, if we want to minimize it, then we want to pull this electron, correct? Pull this negative charge, correct?
Yes, sir.
What CH3 is doing? CH3 is giving more electrons. So, what it will do? It will stabilize it. It will minimize the charge or it will increase the charge?
It will increase.
Then it will destabilize. No? Or yes, did you understand how it will destabilize?
Got it, sir.
Got it. Okay, fine. Now tell me about here, CN. Plus M minus M plus I minus I. What effect?
Minus M.
Minus M. That means stable. Now what about NO2? Plus M minus M plus I minus I.
Plus M.
Huh?
No, no.
Kill you.
No, no. Minus M.
Minus M. Okay. Now we will have, see, first of all, we know the least stable would be, the least stable would be this CH3 one, correct? Because it is destabilizing, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then I can write here B is the most unstable. Then we can write A because it has no stabilizing effect. It has no effect, no stabilizing effect, correct?
Yes, sir.
Then I will write A. Then between the C and D, there will be competition. Which is more minus M? CN is more minus M or NO2? Just go to the previous slide. Tell me. Which comes first? NO2 comes first, na? So NO2 has greater minus I effect than cyanide group, correct?
Yes, sir.
So what I will write here is, tell me, after A, it will come C. And the most acidic will be?
B.
B. Got it?
Okay, sir. 1 minute.
Can I move on?
1 minute, sir.
Okay, I'm writing one more point. Electron donating group will destabilize. The conjugate base and make the acid less acidic. done?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So, ready to do some correct questions?
Okay, sir.
Ready? Okay, fine. So, you have to do again the same thing. You have to arrange in the acidic strength. The first structure is, now I'm giving you phenols only, okay? Phenols only. OH. And let me give you here a Cl group. Can you see this? This is Cl. V. Again, phenol. And let us have a CH3 group here. See, let us have the phenol, same phenol. Bonds OH and NO2. D, let us have the same old phenol and OCH3. OCH3. Okay, now I have to make this a bit above. Yes, start. A, B, C, D. How will you do it, Jubana? How will you do this? First of all, what we do? We recognize the effects that is going on. First of all, recognize the same, similar part. What is the similar part? Similar part is still here. This is similar. This, and everything above is same. Everything above is same. You have to compare what is not similar in all of these structures. Okay.
Okay.
Compare the groups, right? Plus M, minus M, plus I, minus I, whatever you see. Done?
Yes, sir.
Okay, tell me. What is here in A? Plus M, minus M, plus I, minus I. What is there?
In A, it's minus M.
Why minus M? Cl is there now. It has lone pairs now. Cl has lone pairs.
So it's plus
M. Wait a second. Plus M, but what is dominant? Plus M and minus I, both are there. What is dominant? Minus I is dominant. Okay. So plus M does not work here. What works is minus I. Okay. Right. Do you remember? Just keep this in mind, Jubana. Cl. Cl is what? Halogen, na? Chlorine, fluorine, bromine, iodine. All these are
halogen.
In halogens, what happens? Plus M is there. But minus I is dominant.
Okay, sir.
minus M is dominant. Okay, minus I is dominant. Plus M is there, but minus I is dominant. Okay. Now what about this one? We have what? CS3. CS3 has what plus effect? Plus I.
Plus I.
Okay. What about NO2? Plus M, minus M, plus I, minus I.
So minus M.
Minus M. What about OCS3?
I'm confused with that.
Are OCS3? What is the key atom?
O.
Key atom is?
O. Oxygen.
O has lone pair?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Is O attached to electronegative atom?
Yes, sir.
What atom it is attached to electronegative atom? Which atom is electronegative? O is attached to what? Carbon, na?
Carbon.
So carbon is not electronegative, na? What is electronegative? Fluorine, oxygen, nitrogen, etc. Okay, nitrogen, chlorine also is electronegative. Bromine. Carbon is not. Carbon is not. Okay. So it will come to which one? Plus M, because it has lone pair, and it is not attached to any electronegative element. Correct.
Yes, sir.
So this will be plus M. Okay, now tell me what is happening here, stabilizing or destabilizing in A part? In A, what is happening? Stabilizing or destabilizing?
Stabilizing,
stable. What about here? Unstable?
Destabilize.
How it is stable? Plus I will release electron. It is electron donating group. If it is electron donating group, then I have written in the previous slide, electron donating group will destabilize the conjugate base and make the acid less acidic.
So here it's plus I, no?
Here it is plus I. Is it electron donating or electron withdrawing?
Donating.
Yes, that's it. If it is electron donating, then it is increasing the negative charge that is present in the conjugate base, that is O negative. Correct. If it is increasing the electron density at O negative, it is destabilizing it.
Yes, sir. That's what I said, destabilizing.
As you said destabilizing, I heard stabilizing. Destable. Okay. What about this one? Stable, unstable?
Stable.
What happens now? Let me tell you. So you're okay, fine. You say in a very slight voice. What about here plus M?
Unstable.
Unstable. Very good. Say it like this.
Okay.
Unstable. Now you tell me what will be the order. First of all, the least stable. Which will be least stable? The plus one will be least stable. Okay. Anything which has plus. And between mesomeric effect and inductive effect, which wins? Mesomeric always wins, except for halogens. Halogen case is just an exception. Just leave the halogens. If you have a mesomeric effect and an inductive effect, which effect will win? Mesomeric effect. Okay. Now there is a competition between plus I and plus M. Which will win? Plus M will win. So D is the least. D is least. Then we have plus I, which is in B. Then there is a competition between again minus M and minus I. Minus M and minus I. Now who will win?
Minus M.
But so if minus M wins, then I have to put I here. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Then what will come? C. Okay, fine. One more try. What do you say?
Okay, sir.
I mean, I don't know whether the functional groups are left or not, but let us see. I can make something wrong. Same old phenol.
2 minutes, I'll come now.
Okay, fine. I'm just writing the questions now. What else can I say? Let me take the phenols first of all. The phenols are the constant. Mm-hmm.
Sir, I'm back.
And you have your question also. What I have I have tried to help you out here. First of all, be very algorithmic, I mean in a sequential way. First of all, tell me, what is the key atom in A? What is the key atom in A?
C, carbon.
Say carbon, please. Thank you very much. What is in C. B? What is carbon? What is the key atom in the
Nitrogen.
Nitrogen with a lone pair. What is the key atom in the C structure? Sorry, this will be D.
Nitrogen
with a lone pair. Okay. Does it has a lone pair? No, it does not have lone pair. Does this have lone pair? No, it does not have lone pair. Does this have a lone pair? Yes, this has lone pair. Does this have a lone pair? Yes, this has lone pair. Okay, fine, great. Is the key atom bonded to electronegative element? Here, tell me.
Yes,
is the
sir.
Key atom? Yes. Then, is the key atom bonded to electronegative element?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Now, be careful here. Is the key atom bonded to electronegative element?
No, sir.
Very good. Is the key atom bonded to electronegative element? Be very careful here.
Yes, sir. No.
Carbon. This is carbon. No. Yes. Very good. Thank you. Now you tell me. Now, if the key atom is bonded to electronegative element, then what effect does it have? Plus M, minus M, plus I, minus I.
Minus M.
Very good. What about here?
Minus M.
Very good. What about here? The key atom has lone pair. So?
Plus I.
I will give you plus I or plus M?
Plus M.
Very good. And here?
Plus M.
Plus M. Now, you have to know the acidic character. Okay, acidic character. Which will be the most acidic? Minus M1 will be the most acidic, right?
Yes, sir.
Now, between aldehyde and ketone. Between aldehyde and ketone, which is more minus I? I have given you, now.
Aldehyde is more minus M.
See here.
So minus.
Which one?
Ketone.
Oh. Ketone. So, A is, not A, sorry. B is most acidic. Then we have A. Then between NR2 and this NHCO3, which one is more?
So is it B? No, C?
Yes. C is more than a D. So we have to write this is the most acidic, this is the next acidic, this is the next one, then we have the last D one. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now you will do these questions. In your mind, you have to complete this much. This much should be done in your mind.
Okay, sir.
Now this plus M minus M you have to write. Plus M minus M you have to write. Okay. This much, if you do this also, then it would be great. Okay, it would be great. But it takes too much time. Hence, if you do it mentally, it will be better. It will be better. Okay, fine. Now we are done with mesomeric effect. Now the last electron displacement effect. You want to copy this?
Yes.
Okay, sorry.
Done, sir.
Okay. So the last one, the electron displacement effect that we were studying, we had what else did we study? We studied about inductive effect. In that, we studied plus I minus I, resonance effect plus R minus R. Then we studied mesomeric effect plus M and minus M. The last one that is remaining is hyperconjugation. It is also known as no bond resonance. Very dirty. Let me give it a straight line here. No bond resonance. Okay. Now, what is no bond resonance? First of all, see, I should have to make one thing clear. More hyperconjugation means more stable. Okay. Means more stable. Let me get done with the application first of all. Now, whose stability are we talking about? We are talking about the stability of it governs the stability of carbocation. Okay, remember carbocation, alkenes, free radical. Right, and free radical. So if you want to know about the stability of carbocation, alkenes, or free radicals, then this hyperconjugation governs those stability. Okay, it is not, the carbocation is not solely dependent on hyperconjugation, but hyperconjugation can affect the stability of the carbocation, alkenes, and free radicals. Now, what is hyperconjugation? Hyperconjugation is the delocalization of conjugate CH bond. Sigma bond with pi bond. It is either conjugated with pi bond or it is either or by positive charge or free radical. Delocalization of conjugated CH sigma bond with pi bond or positive charge or free radical is called hyperconjugation. Now, what is the condition for hyperconjugation? Conditions. The number one condition is at least one sp2 hybridized. We should have at least one sp2 hybridized carbon atom. At least one sp2 hybridized carbon atom, or you will have, or either alkene, even alkene also have sp2, alkenes also have sp2, alkene or carbocation, I mean all of them, carbocation also has sp2, alkene also have sp2, and free radical also have sp2. So I don't want to write it again and again. At least one sp2 hybridized. Now the alpha carbon with respect to sp2 hybridized carbon atom, it should have at least one hydrogen. Now you can also write this as at least one alpha hydrogen. What does all these mean? Let me tell you. For example, we have this compound. Let us take Let us take this CH2 positive, and it is joined with C, which has H, H, and H. Now you see sigma, sigma, and positive charge. If we had A double bond B and single bond C positive charge, we call this as resonance. If we have a sigma CH and then again a sigma, then a positive charge, now we will be having hyperconjugation or no bond resonance. Now how will this take place? How will this take place? It will be simply like this. Now what will happen? CH2 double bond C. Here we'll be having H2 and here we'll be having H plus. Correct? If I expand this and write, I can write, show it like this. CH2 will be simply CH2. I'm writing it again here, CH2. Now this carbon will be having H plus like this, and the two hydrogens will be as it is. Otherwise, what can happen is it can form again bond here, and this can break. Correct? This can break. So one more structure that we can get is either CH2 double bond C. This H is there. This H is also there. Now this H has gone H plus. Another structure that we can get is CH2 C. These are there, and the middle one has been broken. Okay. So how many structures did we get? Number of no bond resonating structure. No bond resonating structure is equal to 3. And if you look at this carbon, which is called this carbon, and the carbon which has the positive charge, or this is the sp2 carbon atom, the carbon atom which is next to sp2, this carbon atom, it is called alpha carbon. Now number of hydrogens in alpha carbon, alpha C, is equal to how much? Is equal to 3. And this is also the number of resonating structure that we are forming. Now, more hyperconjugating structures gives more stability. That means I can say, now the hyperconjugating structure is dependent on the number of alpha hydrogens. So I will say more alpha hydrogens give us more stability. Got it?
Yes, sir. Got it.
Okay, fine. Previous. Achha, did you know about this concept of hyperconjugation earlier, previously?
Sir, I didn't remember.
Okay, fine, great. Copy this and let me know when you're done.
So what is the second point it governs?
It governs the stability of carbocation, alkenes, and free radicals. I mean, it can affect the stability of carbocation. I mean, it will stabilize carbocation, alkenes, and free radicals. As soon as the hyperconjugation will increase, the stability of carbocation will increase, the stability of alkenes will increase, the stability of free radicals will increase.
Okay, sir. Done, sir.
Okay, next slide.
Done, sir.
Great. Now I am giving you some questions. You have to find, tell me the number of alpha hydrogens, okay? Not calculate, you have to find. Find is a better word. Find the number of alpha hydrogens in the following. In the following. Option number one, CH2 positive, and we have CH2, CH3. Write the CH2 more clearly. 2 CH2 C positive, and we write here NH and CH3. Three. We have just to calculate the number of alpha hydrogens. Four. Yes, six questions, and do these. It is easy, na? You do you want me to do one of the questions? Do you want me to do one of the questions? Anyone?
No, sir, I'll just try it.
Okay, fine. Do it then. Done, Jubana?
No, sir.
Where are, in which question are you there?
Sam, going through fifth one.
Okay, fine then. Great. don't look at this numbering that I am doing, okay? Done?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Now, first, if you will tell me, in the question number one, I have numbered 1, 2, 3, and second, third, fourth. In each of them, I have numbered some of the carbons. Okay, I have numbered the carbons.
Okay, sir.
Right?
Yes, sir.
Now, you have to tell me which of the following is alpha carbon. In the question number one, tell me which is the alpha carbon.
Question number one, 2 is the alpha carbon.
In question number 2, which is the alpha carbon?
Question number 2.
This one.
The one is the alpha carbon.
This one is the alpha carbon?
Yes, sir.
Okay, what about 3?
Over there. See, 3 is the alpha carbon.
Okay, what about 4? In fourth question, which is the alpha carbon?
First one.
Okay. In fifth, which is the alpha carbon?
So in fifth, fourth and third one, it can be 2 carbons, right? 4 and 6 in fifth one, and in fourth one, 1 and 5 and 2 can be there, right?
1 and 5, no?
Yes. And third one, it can be 3, right? Because...
Yes. And question 2,
no,
1 and 3.
Yeah.
In question 3 also, right?
Yeah.
No?
Yes, sir.
But not in question 1. Because yes, adjacent to, not in question 1. What about here? Here it will be, this 1 carbon is alpha carbon, this 3 carbon is alpha carbon, this 9th carbon is alpha carbon. Correct? Okay, fine.
Yes, sir.
Now we will look at the alpha hydrogens. Alpha hydrogens. How many hydrogens does this carbon have? It has 2.
Yes, sir.
Correct? Yes, what about, sir, this one? This has 6. Now this will be having 9, correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay, let me write this. I write writing alpha H's, alpha hydrogen, alpha hydrogen. Now here, how many?
There, it's 2. No.
Here it is 2. Here it is 2, correct? So 4 alpha hydrogens here. What about here in fifth question? How many alpha hydrogens? Look at this carbon. This carbon has how many bonds? 1, 2, 3, 4 bonds. That means no other bond is left, right? If I want to write it in the expanded form, I will write it like this. CH3, it is bonded to some carbon. Now it is bonded to again CH3. It is again bonded to C positive. Now it is again bonded to CH3. Now this carbon, the fourth carbon, all the valencies of fourth carbon has been fulfilled. That means no alpha hydrogen is present in the carbon 4. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. The similar is the case for sixth. The fourth carbon and the sixth carbon both have the same configuration. 1, 2, 6 carbon also has 4 bonds. That means no other bond is left to be formed via hydrogen. Correct?
Yes, sir.
That means 0 alpha hydrogens. The alpha carbon here and alpha carbon here has no hydrogens, right?
Yes, sir.
So 0 alpha hydrogen, no? Do you have any confusion there? I think you have some confusion there. No, no? Okay, fine. Yes, what about this one? Now this particular, this one has CH3. That means 3 alpha hydrogen from here. Now this carbon has how many bonds? 3 bonds. So one bond will be made by hydrogen. This also has how many bonds? This has 3 bonds. So another bond will be by hydrogen. So this particular carbon atom has 1, 2, 3 alpha carbons, and in one of the alpha carbon there is 3 + 1 + 1, that is equal to 5 alpha hydrogens. How many of your answers were right?
Four. So I didn't get the sixth one. Rest everything is correct. No, fifth and sixth is wrong for me.
Okay, but you understood the fifth one?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Do one thing. Just tell me how to draw this, okay? This is the structure, na? Here also? Right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, just tell me if I am drawing it right or not. Okay, just tell me. Use this color. Carbon. Sorry. Carbon. I am writing from here. Carbon. Because it is, I am just writing the alpha carbons. Okay. So this carbon. This carbon. This carbon. Am I right? This will be, I can write, this is CH3. This is CH3. This is positively charged. Okay. Now tell me how many bonds this carbon has made already. Three bonds.
Three.
So one will be hydrogen. One will be with hydrogen. Yes, right? Sir. It is hidden. Now what about this carbon? How many bonds does it have now?
Three.
Only one bond? This carbon.
Yes, sir. One bond.
So how many hydrogens should it be attached to?
Three.
What about this carbon? How many bonds it has? One, two, and three. So how many hydrogens should I make bond? One. So how many? This is alpha. This is alpha. This is alpha. So in one alpha, we have three alpha hydrogen. Plus here we have how many alpha hydrogen?
One
alpha hydrogen. Here we have how many alpha hydrogen? Plus one alpha hydrogen. So we equal to five alpha hydrogens.
Yes, sir. Clear, sir.
Clear? Okay, fine. You want to copy this?
Yes, sir.
Okay, copy.
Done, sir.
And great. Now let us look at hyperconjugation in radicals. Hyperconjugation in free radicals. How this will take place? Free radicals. We have, for example, CH3 and CH2 free radical. CH3, CH2 free radical. If you want to make a picture, you can make a picture like this. This carbon has H a bond with this another carbon, correct? And this particular carbon is sp2 because this p orbital has a free radical. This one electron is free radical, and the others are sp2 hybridized. Correct. Now what I am doing here is I am just greening these. Okay, now you tell me this is what? This is sp3 hybridized carbon atom. Now what is this one? This is sp2 hybridized carbon atom. And this is the free radical. This is the free radical, okay? Now let us see how the hyperconjugation takes place. I can write this structure like this. H, C, and CH2 is there. So as a free radical. If I want to elaborate this one of the CH bond, all of the CH bonds are same, but I want to elaborate this CH bond. Let me write it like this. And let me use some different colors here. Okay. Now what can happen is So electron going to go to H. This electron can come here. This electron can also come here. Now what will happen if this particular thing happens is, if this type of phenomena happens, then I can write it like this. Carbon. Now H will be having a free radical here. The other two H will be intact to the carbon atom. And a double bond will be formed via this atom and that atom. And I will be getting CH2. Now you have to mind this one thing, that this new bond that has been formed is by this one electron from the carbon free radical, and the electron, other electron is the sigma electron of the CH bond. The second electron is of sigma bond of CH atom. Now similarly, what other hybrid structures can I make? Sorry, the hyperconjugating structures can I make? I can make this structure. Oh, sorry, not red. I have to use black. CH2, then we have CH radical double bond CH2, correct? So again, number of no bond resonating structures is equal to number of alpha hydrogen, correct? Right or wrong? Sahi? Okay, fine. Did you understand? You understood this, na?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Now, similarly, if I want to ask you the stability of free radical, that means the more the number of alpha hydrogen. Let me write it. Stability of free radical will be proportional to the number of, this hash is for number, okay? Hash is for number. No bond resonating structures, okay? Now what is this dependent on? This directly depends on number of alpha hydrogens. So you have to just see the number of alpha hydrogen for the stability of free radical, okay? Now the next thing that I want to teach you is the hyperconjugation in alkenes. Yes.
1 minute, last page, last slide.
You have to ask something?
No, completing.
You have to note it down? Okay, fine. Done?
No, sir.
Hey, this looks beautiful. I don't know why. So much of self-praise, but this looks beautiful. The green shaded part. Do you agree?
Yes, sir, it's colorful. Okay, then, sir.
Hyperconjugation in alkenes. How you will see hyperconjugation in alkenes, and how, remember, CH, then you will be having again a CH and a double bond CH2. Now what will happen? This will go here. This will go here. And you can make H, C, and you can write it here H plus. And this will be double bonded. And this will be CH again. Now this will be CH2 negative. Sorry, one more H will be there. Other thing that you can write is, you can make this H plus and CH again double bond. This will be CH single bond CH2 negative. One more you can write is this will be H plus double bonded with CH single bonded with CH2 negative. Got it? Here also stability of alkene is directly proportional to number of alpha hydrogen. Now you should remember, this is the sp2 carbon. Done?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Two simple short questions, then we will end this class. Arrange. I mean, you have to just be the order of stability. Okay, not wasting so much of time. CH3 free radical, A part, B part is CH3 free radical bonded to, let us say, oh, sorry. This will be CH2, not CH3. This will be CH2. CH2 free radical bonded to CH3. C would be CH2 free radical bonded to this is one question. Question number one. The another question will be of alkenes. Let us take an alkene. CH3 here. CH3. Done.
Are you done writing the question at least, Jubaina?
Yes, I'm completing the question.
In your head, do you have some kind of answer going on? Can you see those? Which is more stable?
So, in which way we have to arrange it?
Arrange it in, first you arrange it in decreasing order. Arrange it in decreasing order.
Decreasing order of free radical?
Decreasing order of stability of the decrease. Arrange the following in decreasing order of stability. Stability.
So can you help out?
Okay, fine. Tell me how many alpha hydrogens here? What is there any alpha carbon here?
No, sir.
So no. What how many which is this is alpha carbon here?
One.
And what is the alpha hydrogen? Number of alpha hydrogen?
Three.
Now which is the alpha carbon here? This is the alpha carbon. This is also the alpha carbon. Right?
Yes, sir.
Now, how many alpha hydrogens total?
Six.
Now, what about here? How many alpha hydrogens here?
There are three are there.
Alpha hydrogens. Nine. How many alpha? Nine alpha hydrogens. So, D will be most stable, then C, then B. Got it? Now, tell me here, this is sp2? This is also sp2, correct?
Yes, sir.
How many alpha hydrogen for this sp2? How many alpha carbon, tell me? How many is it? Does this carbon have any other carbon attached to itself? That no. is sp3? No.
No.
How many to this one? There are, this has alpha, this is alpha. So alpha hydrogen is equal to how much?
Two. No.
Two.
Oh, yeah.
Two, sorry, alpha carbon is 2. Yes, alpha hydrogen will be equal to?
6.
6. How many alpha hydrogens here?
Alpha hydrogen.
How Three. Many alpha carbons? How many alpha carbons? 3 alpha carbon?
Yes,
this
sir.
This is also alpha. This is also alpha. This is also alpha. So how many hydrogens are there total? 9. And here?
4 carbons are there, so 12.
Oh, very good. 12 alpha hydrogens. Okay, good, great. So we are done with hyperconjugation also. We are done with hyperconjugation also. And in the next class, do you have idea on aromaticity?
No, sir.
I mean, aromaticity, I can leave because there is a few things. You will not get direct questions on aromaticity. But the next thing that I have to start is reaction intermediate, I guess. Reaction intermediate. What is it? Reaction intermediate? Reaction intermediate are either carbocation, and we'll be dealing majorly with carbocation. Then we will be dealing with carbon ion, free radical. A little bit about free radical, and then we will deal a bit about carbene, nitrene, and benzene. Okay, I mean just the definition of these three. Most important is carbocation. A slight few things about carbonine and free radical, and very little about carbene, nitrene, and benzene. Okay, carbene. You have seen carbocation many times, right? You have seen yes. carbocations. So don't worry, we will deal in greater detail with carbocations. And have you ever seen the chapter alkyl halide?
Yes, sir.
So in that also you have seen carbocation? No?
Yes, sir.
Right. So there also you have carbocation. So we will deal with carbocation first. Then a bit about carbon. I guess in one lecture I can finish all these four. These four. Okay. So I'm ending this class now. We will meet on next class.
Okay, sir.
When is the next class?
Saturday, Sunday.
Ah, good. Sunday. Okay.